some get back. Payback. Payback.
Hey, brother, how you doing? Why are you out here like this in the street, man? That's the richest country in the world. President Barack Obama, State Senator Huntley, this guy's right here in front of your office, State Senator Huntley. Why is this guy like this out in the street, Senator Huntley? Malcolm Smith has just accused you of selling houses on land you didn't know. What's with this Democratic leadership in Southeast Queens? He's urinating in the street. He's out. He's incapacitated. Somebody ought to do something about that. President Obama, can you help me? I sent you an SOS in the letter to the president. My name is Dr. Philip Dreis, and this is an abomination.
Got it right. Woo! Morgan. Holland Cuss. You want a bank? Payback is a thing you got to see. Hell! Never do any damn thing to me.
go to the library.
The library?
I do.
Okay, so you listen.
What?
You can't go to the library right now.
Why not?
Because it's facing a tough time.
Huh?
A tough time.
What are you talking about?
Well, the library needs help. It has a deficit.
Uh-huh.
A deficit. That means it's facing a hard economic crisis. And we need the government's help to raise money for the funds. The library is a beautiful place, you know, right?
I like your library. And it's a place of books, large movies, computers.
Yeah, so right now, we need a lot of money from the government.
Okay.
So tell Mr. President, say to the camera, Mr. President, we need your help.
Mr. President, we need your help so, so much, okay? You hear me? We need your help.
Who does?
The library, okay? The library needs our help right now.
The Queens County Library.
The Queens County Library needs our help right now. Thank you so much.
Bye. feeling. I can dig rapping. I'm ready. I can dig scrapping. But I can't dig that backstabbing. Don't do me no done favor. I don't know karate, but I know crazy.
This is the Falling Paint Chips. We're talking about total lack of services. And from the view of this apartment, there is no way Ms. Green went and spent, and her daughter even said on tape, she's had this furniture here since she's been here. So the 20-some thousand dollars that's missing with Mitchell. Now, right, now.
But I have the paper stating whose name is in it, on it, Hosea Mitchell or whatever her name is.
Hosea Mitchell.
Yeah.
Now, when you went to the bank, they mentioned something. Could you tell us that from your own words, please, about what happened, about her saying that the daughter was deceased and that's why how she got her name on the bank account?
Oh, I'm her only child. I was living on Clarkson Avenue. I'm quite sure I lived at least 8 or 9 years, but I can prove I'm not moving from place to place. But what I understand, my mother had nobody. She said she sent me the post office thing for me to sign. I know what apartment I was in, and she sent them. She'd have got them back or something like that. She has no evidence or nothing like that.
Okay. Now, what happened when you went for that interview with Victoria Cruz in the Inspector General's office again, please?
Concerning what way?
Concerning the check I mean the stolen money or the missing money.
Oh, they just told me they was gonna take care of it and not talk to nobody and this and that and other.
How much money did she tell you that was that?
She told me it was $20,000. The only time she contacted me is she wanna know what's going on.
Okay.
I have no help from them at all.
And you know Mitchell recently got fired.
No, I heard it was a rumor.
No, she's been terminated from housing, and she's still on tenant patrol downstairs. Now, why don't you tell us about that situation that you had mentioned before, in your own words, not what I thought I heard, about her hitting your niece that was coming in the building and stuff while she was on tenant patrol.
My daughter.
Oh, your daughter.
That's pregnant.
Uh-huh.
Was coming in the building.
Uh-huh.
And she had her. My son, if he want to come in the building, she won't even open the door for him or nothing like that. Claim she never know who he is. But he'll be around tomorrow.
Okay.
He'll always try to check on mom.
Did she hit your daughter?
Yeah.
She was pregnant and Mitchell had physical contact with her that was inappropriate.
From what I understand, I'm not worrying about that. I'm worrying about my mother's money.
Yes, and...
Because right now, my mother has a light bill, which I got in touch with the welfare on Jamaica Avenue or something, which I guess is a reply. They're getting ready to cut her lights off. And also, the man was out here. She has no Medicaid. She has no home attendant.
Right, and that's, is that because...
All this goes with the thing, but they put a freeze on everything on my mother's.
And that was done by the Inspector General's office?
I don't know who it was done by, but it has something to do with this case with her money being missing.
Right, and it was Alzia Mitchell attempting to become a representative payee with Social Security and with the missing money, that's why her Medicare and Medicaid, all that is missing and she can't get a home attendant.
I understand it has something to do with it. Well, listen to this. I walked in the bank one day because Ms. Mitchell put an insurance policy, accident insurance policy on my mother.
Mitchell put an insurance policy against your mother's death.
Accident, yeah. I walked in the bank and they asked me, I remember very clearly, had my mother had an accident because somebody else she had one on, but this is just hearsay, he had deceased.
Oh, that's the man that with the missing check. With the stolen check?
I don't know. So, they asked me that. Had my mother deceased. She had an accident. I said, what do you mean an accident?
Oh, so Mitchell put an accidental life insurance policy on your mother, and the bank was told that your mother was deceased, and somebody trying to collect that money?
No, when I went in there, they asked me that. You see right here?
Okay.
This is where I had to go and try to get her utility bill paid.
Okay.
It's right there. $600. She'd have been able to keep up with her bills. She don't have change, the right change of clothes, no nothing right now.
And you and your family have been the only ones that have been charged with taking care of sole support
of
your mother.
$312 or $20-some. That's a husband's benefit. Now in the morning I'm gonna get up and try to go to Social Security Board and see what I can do there. It's hard trying to feed her and everything else. It's very hard. I wish somebody would help me.
Well, I'm going to make sure that I take this to the Supreme Court judge because I'm filing an Article 76 motion in Supreme Court. Hopefully, they can subpoena Chino Hernandez, Douglas Apple, Judith Abruzzo, the Inspector General, and Ricardo Antonio Morales, who's the head of legal. All of them know this because I bug them. I call up their phone, leave messages. Nobody calls me back. I've been complaining for 2 years about your mother. We just met not too long ago.
Another thing, anything they can put against her now to put her out, they're doing it. I got receipts where her rent was paid.
Yes.
They put us in court last month.
Right, I remember. I saw you going to court.
And all like that. Anything they can get against her, I don't understand. What's the man's name, Mr. Perry or Clark or whatever?
Yeah, Clark, the tall, light-skinned guy.
The only way I got him off my back, I had to bring my husband in here. I had to go get papers and make copies of that. I had a place to stay because he said I was staying here with my mother.
Exactly what he... Okay. Clark has been... I don't want to get...
The other day on the elevator.
Yeah, remember when I saw you, remember what I said? Don't let him sucker you into signing a whole bunch of papers and getting you to do things in order to help evict your mother out of here.
Yeah. I don't know. See,
yeah, there you go. You hear that, Judge?
I don't know.
Glenn Clark has been trying to scare other people here. That's been NYCHA's modus operandi of trying to scare black people out of this apart, out of this building, in order, I don't know for what.
Listen, I had to get a paper for my 13-year-old son, my, believe it or not, grandbaby. He wasn't even a year old.
Wait, and
my
Clark
was pregnant with one, and the other one wasn't even a year old, and myself, with our address, which some had been mailed to us recently.
Uh-huh. I dare you to say it on camera.
I will say it.
Okay, say it on camera.
Mrs. Mitchell is a danger.
Okay, let me get from
yeah,
my...
Yeah, because I'm going to talk.
Right, okay. No, that's okay. That's okay. Now, tell us the story from about the stolen check. Look, you're not looking bad. No, you're not looking bad. Now, because I got a close-up, all right? Well, all right. Now, Mabel, tell us your name, where you live at, and tell us... No. Tell me your name, your phone number, and what you observed about the stolen check of Mr. Saxton and the whole scenario with the district attorney and everything.
My name is May Keys. I was approached by Mrs. Mitchell. I was on my way to the library on Merrick Road, and she said, I want to take a walk with you. And as we came back and returned to my mother's place here.
Right.
She showed me a check and said, this is James' check, Saxton's check. I'm going to cash it because he didn't earn it. And as far as I'm concerned, that's what happened.
She stole a check from the mail room downstairs,
right.
Went and took the check and cashed the check, said she was going to cash the check.
He said she was going to cash it.
Right.
Because he wasn't going to get it.
Because he wasn't going to get it because he didn't earn it.
Right.
That's the, and right. And what about what happened after that? Because you... You told him that she had stole, that...
I informed him, yes.
You informed him...
That's
right.
The reason why I told him.
Right.
Other than that, I would have never told him.
Right. And you told him, and then he went to the DA...
To try to get help.
Right. And then he also wanted you and Miss Williams to accompany him to court something, right?
He asked me for an affidavit, or whatever my recollection was.
Mm-hmm.
What happened?
Right.
I told him the same thing I'm saying to you.
Right.
I did see the woman with the check, with the man's name on it, but...
And it was a New York City housing check.
From the little work he done.
From the work he did with Miss Canty downstairs.
He had looked for that check for a long time.
And that's the man that came up dead days before he was supposed to be with the DA at criminal court. I think everybody's got that. Now, you had mentioned something else before we started that Mitchell is a danger. Yeah,
she is a danger to all the vulnerable elderly people here, and she's forever threatening people, ever, because I have a case against her myself. I have a document of her threatening me. That's it.
Because Ms. Barlow seen her with a hammer coming looking for me. And downstairs, I got her on tape saying she came after come after me with a golf club because of the thing with her getting fired. And NYCHA, remember you had told this to the investigator Victoria Cruz about the stolen check of Mr. Saxton?
Of course.
And on my telephone in my house. And she never called you for you to be deposed and for you to tell it or anything. And I believe, personally, it was an attempt to cover up that crime for Mitchell.
Probably.
Because it's so big, it would have brought in the feds.
They still should be on this. It is a federal defense. Anytime you go in mail and steal somebody's mail, and no matter what it might be, but this was a real check. City check belonging to Mrs. Jackson. As she pursued it, she stole it, and she cast it. And whatever else happened, I cannot say. I can only go by what was said to me.
And the man did come up dead days before he's supposed to go to criminal court for her to be indicted.
Exactly.
And NYCHA don't want to have anything to do with it. They never called you back after you told them that the investigator never. Victoria Cruz is fired, I hear.
Wonderful. They all need to be fired because they are no good. From top to bottom. They're no good. None of them. Because they don't respond to things that are important and that need urgently attention. They don't do it. Simple as that.
Thank you, Mabel. I'm going to go downstairs and get me some Chinese food, baby. All right, Mommy. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you.
All right.
Yeah, I don't know anything else but the truth. That's what I saw with my eyes.
That's it.
My eyes and sight.
That's why
I didn't ask for it because I didn't know anything about it. I knew nothing of this. I wasn't interested in it because I don't listen to stuff like that.
And you know she... Were you aware or witness to her abusing senior citizens, like yelling at them, abusing them, and that sort of thing?
Forever calling people stupid and using very profanity language.
That's exactly what Miss Harper said. Calling these old people stupid.
And using profanity language.
And using profanity against them. What about the yelling and the screaming?
Frightening them, abusive, or... You know, out of character.
Abusive behavior, totally out of character.
The behavior is totally out of character. There's no reason for this woman to behave this way towards innocent, vulnerable people.
Mr. Commissioner, Mr. Chairman Tino Hernandez, you get that. Mr. Douglas Apple, you can't say you don't know about it. I contacted you. Judith Abruzov, the Inspector General's office, you fired Victoria Cruz because she was part of the conspiracy that was trying to help Miss Green's daughter. You know about that one.
Oh, yes, I do. Yes, I do. That's very bad. She embezzled the woman out of her money.
And went and bought the mink coats in that car.
Hey, thank you.
And nobody want to believe it. I mean, they act like somebody. Now I see why she calls everybody stupid. Because what she does is so outrageous. If you tell it to strangers, they probably never believe it. Unless there's collaboration by a bunch of people. And that's what I'm trying to get here.
You pull this with somebody with a little intelligence and some type of, you know, common sense.
Common sense.
Common sense. That's all it is. Common sense. You know when somebody beat you for one thing, you don't allow them to come back and take thousands of dollars and embezzle your money from your account, go and then let them sign where they can take control of your account. The woman is stealing the people's money. Honestly. Because they are allowing it. They are afraid of her. That's why.
And the nepotism that got her on that job of tenant patrol supervisor by Isaac Perry is another thing that needs to be investigated. If she got fired from NYCHA for cause, what is she doing still? It's almost like a Brown of FEMA that got fired for his incompetence in Louisiana and he still got a consultant job making more money. That's bureaucratic, political nonsense. We need to take it to a judge.
Hey, Mr. Clark, calling from the New York City Housing Authority. I have a message for Alta Grace. Mr. Philip Dreyfus, if you give me a call back as soon as possible, it's an urgent matter. Seems there's some kind of violation going on. I want to get to the bottom of it. Thanks. Have a nice day.
Thursday, 11:29 a.m.
Hello, this is a message from Ms. Alta Grace Dreyfus. It's important that you give us a call at the management office at Baisley Houses. We would prefer that you don't let Mr. Philip Dreyfus call us because we have some problems regarding him. We need, if you have another relative that speaks English and can translate for you, to contact us. It would be greatly appreciated. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thursday, 2:23 p.m.
introducing Dr. Tube the Crusader.
Check yourself before the police check you.
Introducing the Alco Tube Plus.
A portable, disposable cigarette-sized breathalyzer tester with a patented formula that makes our machine as accurate as the machine in the back of that police car.
Take the Dr. Tube Challenge.
Test it before you drive it. Don't risk it. Don't get caught dead drunk behind the wheel of that car, please.
That party was hot,
yeah,
y'all.
That was pretty good. He had no clothes. Let's go home.
Baby, where you going?
What do you mean,
that's a police car. 15 days. We're not allowed to drive, baby.
No,
baby, I'm going to call the cat. Good drunk. I'm calling the cat. That's it.
Hi there.
Excuse me, sir. I have a couple. Maybe tomorrow we'll go home.
Listen,
what are you doing?
You know this guy?
Yes, that's Dr. Tube.
You're drunk.
That's Dr. Tube, the Crusader. He's been on TV.
You're drunk.
He knows who's drunk. Listen to him.
No drinking, sir.
I'd like to introduce you to the opposite.
What is that? It's a portable, disposable, cigarette-sized breathalyzer tester that's as accurate as the machine in the back of that police car. Mm-hmm. That is not your car.
This is my car. How are you going to tell me
that? That is not your car.
Take the Dr. Tube Challenge. Test it before you drive it. Don't risk it. Don't get caught dead drunk behind the wheel of that car, please.
Please take the test, please.
I'm a friend. Trying to help.
Trying to help me?
Yes.
Nice. I'm going to take it.
Good.
Thank you.
Now what? It's good, baby.
You're drunk. You cannot drive.
We can go.
We're calling the cab.
No, we can go.
We're taking you home tonight.
You're going to take me home.
We're taking you home tonight.
You're over here.
We're taking you home tonight.
Introducing Alco Tube Plus, a portable, disposable, cigarette-sized, all-glass breath tester with a patented formula that makes our machine as accurate as the machine in the back of any police car. Take the Dr. Tube Challenge. Test it before you drive it. Don't risk it. Don't get caught dead drunk behind the wheel of that car, please. Drunk driving incidents cost our economy over $86 billion every year. But those experts cannot calculate the cost of human misery caused by drunk driving accidents to families of drunk driving victims. Whether it be an arrest, an accident with injuries, or the dreadful fatalities we all deplore, we are at war, and it began before Iraq. Dr. Tube the Crusader evokes the War Powers Act against drunk driving, and together we shall dethrone the number one preventable health hazard in our great empire by the year 2015.
You are not your political appointees at NYCHA. Will not stick a piece of wood like this up my like your representatives of the New York City Police Department did to Mr. Luima. You got that?
That was the stick, Mr. Bloomberg.
Child grows up to be somebody you just love to burn.